The opposition is calling it the big vaccine loot in Punjab. 40,000 doses of Covaxin bought from the centre for the 18 to 44 year category age group were sold off to private hospitals. The opposition is claiming that the Punjab government purchased these vaccines for 400 rupees but sold them first to hospitals for 1,000 rupees plus, and then the hospitals in turn sold them to customers for 1,500 rupees and more. The Punjab government is under heavy fire. They've issued clarification saying that they're putting the scheme to a halt. But the biggest question is, why was the Punjab government trying to profiteer from the pandemic in the first place?
Punjab Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh is in the line of fire over an alleged vaccine scam in the state. Opposition, Bharatiya Janata Party, Shiromani Akali Dal and the Aam Aadmi Party have launched a scathing attack on the Punjab government on acquiring coronavirus vaccines from vaccine manufacturers at 400 rupees a jab and then selling it to private hospitals at 1,060 rupees per dose, making a profit of 660 rupees per dose. Private hospitals in turn stand accused of charging people in the state anything between 1,500 to 1,700 a dose, thereby making a profit of more than 500 and 50 rupees a dose. Union Information and Broadcasting Minister Prakash Javadekar accused the Congress of trying to make a profit from the pandemic.
कोविन जैसे वैक्सीनेशन में भी वो राज्य सरकार प्रॉफिट ही कमाना चाहती है, तो ये कैसा जनता का प्रशासन है?
In Punjab, Sukhbir Singh Badal of the Shiromani Akali Dal sought the dismissal of the state health minister Balbir Singh and a probe by a sitting High Court judge into what he described was Punjab's vaccine scam.
Captain Amrinder Singh, ਇਸ ਬਿਮਾਰੀ ਤੋਂ ਪੈਸਾ ਕਮਾਉਣ ਲੱਗੇ? ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੀ ਜਾਨਾਂ ਪਰਵਾਹ ਨਹੀਂ, ਪਰ ਪੈਸੇ ਸਰਕਾਰ ਪੈਸਾ ਬਣਾਉਣ ਲੱਗ ਗਈ ਤੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਚਹੇਤਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਪੈਸਾ ਕਮਾਉਣ ਦਾ ਸਾਧਨ ਬਣਾਤਾ.
The opposition has hit out at what Badal called was hypocrisy of the Congress party seeking free vaccination for all and then selling vaccines to make a hefty profit. The Aam Aadmi Party too attacked the Congress government in the state for allegedly profiteering from the pandemic.
हमने ये सुना था कि राज्य सरकारें वैक्सीन के लिए पैसा इकट्ठा करती हैं, लेकिन ये पहली बार सुन रहे हैं कि एक राज्य सरकार वैक्सीन से पैसा बना रही है, पैसा इकट्ठा कर रही
है. The opposition even accused the state government of acting as agents of private hospitals after Punjab Chief Secretary tweeted the cost and availability of vaccines at two major private hospitals. Under intense opposition fire, the Punjab Health Minister Balbir Singh announced the decision, taking back the order to sell vaccines at a profit to private hospitals.
जो हमारा बड सेशन था उसमें सबसे पहले उन्होंने बोला सबको ये जो वैक्सीन है फ्री लगाई जाएगी, तो फ्री लगाने का हमारा जो फैसला वो अटल है, तो इसलिए जो कोई फैसला हुआ कल आज उसको हमने वापस ले लिया.
But the opposition remains unsparing, saying there should be an investigation into vaccine administration in Congress-run states of Punjab, Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan.
Punjab government has taken a U-turn on selling vaccines in the private hospitals. Amid the mounting pressure from the opposition, the government now says that it will provide vaccines for free to the people, as there is a united call for a probe into the alleged scam of jabs by opposition parties, including Shiromani Akali Dal, Bharatiya Janata Party and Aam Aadmi Party. With video journalist Dilip Sahu, this is Manjit Sehgal in Chandigarh for India Today.
What was the Punjab government even thinking? How could they possibly think it would be okay to profiteer from this pandemic? Joining me on the news track tonight, I want to welcome first Dr. Ajay Kumar, national spokesperson for the Congress party. Squaring off against him will be Manjinder Singh Sirsa from the Akali Dal. We have Raghav Chadda, who's leading the AAPS campaign in Punjab, MLA of the Aam Aadmi Party, vice chairperson of the Delhi Jal Board. Last but not least, RP Singh, national secretary of the Bharatiya Janata Party. You've got over here, Ajay Kumar, a situation where the central government sells to the Punjab government vaccines at 420 rupees a dose. For some reason, instead of giving these vaccines away to citizens for free, which is what they should have done, the state government hands these over to private hospitals at 1,060. That's a 2x markup. And the hospitals, the private hospitals, in turn, sell them to citizens for 1,560 rupees a dose, 4x more than what the central government sold that vaccine jab to the state government for. Why was the government of Captain Amrinder Singh in Punjab trying to profiteer from this pandemic, Dr. Kumar?
So, a couple of things, Rahul. I really appreciate the way you've covered the story. A week back, there was the same story about Tejasvi Surya and the BJP scam in Bangalore. But the alacrity in which that news gets reported is, I don't know
if you watched India Today or not, but we reported on that story very extensively. I've asked you some specific question, and I appreciate if you answer the question. Because we covered that story very extensively. I'm not seeking a certificate from you on what I should and should not be doing. I've asked you a direct question and appreciate a direct answer.
I'll definitely answer it. But if you've asked me, I have the right to speak my mind out on a couple of things. So first question is whether we're covering all the issues. And this issue is we definitely believe that the Punjab government made a bad decision. But let us remember that this is a decision which is made by the government in black and white. It is not a scam. It's a decision made by the government in paper. They are not siphoning off the vaccine. They have written it in the file that we are distributing 40,000 out of the 14,000 was made available. So first of all, whether the decision was very bad. Yes, it was. I don't think it was a smart decision, and the government has also accepted it. But the fact to use it scam, because it's a government notification saying that, listen, we've got this 400 rupees, we're going to give it to the private players for...
What I'm asking you, because you're again answering a question I didn't ask. I never said that the government siphoned off these jabs. I asked you a direct question. Why would a government buy for 400 from the central government, sell to citizens ultimately at a price of 1,500? Why was this being done in the first place? Why was there an instinct to make money from these vaccines?
So the issue was the nodal officer in charge, Mr. Garg, and his statement, which has been released, is that since there were two hospitals in whole of Punjab, one was Max, another one was Fortis, if I remember, there were only two hospitals which were able to acquire those vaccines, and the rest of the whole of the Punjab. So this is limited only to the period area around Chandigarh and its twin cities, tri-cities of Chandigarh area. And since rest of Punjab private hospitals were unable to get access to any kind of vaccine, and that's what Mr. Garg, the nodal officer in charge of this, has said. That's why they made it available at the rate which the private hospital would have got it from the vaccine manufacturer.
No, but that's what I'm asking. If you're making it available to private hospitals, you could have given it for 400 rupees itself. Why could you not have given it at the same? That's the point, Raghav Chadha, that the Congress is not answering satisfactorily. It's not as if there's a problem in the state government handing these over to the private hospitals. It is the impulse to profiteer from the pandemic, which is highly questionable, Raghav Chadha.
Look, first of all, the vaccines that belong to the state quota that should have been ideally administered to citizens absolutely free of cost at the government-run centers were diverted to private hospitals. An artificial shortage, and I say these things with a sense of responsibility, Rahul, an artificial shortage of vaccines in the state of Punjab was created by the Captain Amrinder government. Then you sell these vaccines to the private hospitals, they further charge, they add a premium to it and charge an exorbitant price from the people of the state of Punjab. And a dose of vaccine that should have costed 0 rupees to an ordinary citizen was being sold to them at a price of 1,520 rupees. Now, if this is not black marketing, then what is? Something that should have been made available at zero cost is being made available to a citizen at rupees 1,520 rupees.
Manjinder
number
Singh
one.
Says, okay.
Number two, Rahul. You see, it is also important to understand who all are involved in this, who all have received the kickbacks, because the process is very simple. You sell a commodity that is perceived to be scarce to a private institution. That private institution sells it at a higher price, and the private institution usually bribes some members of the government, of the administration. Now, my question is, was there any change of money? Who all were involved? What was the amount of kickbacks? Who were the ministers involved? And the Captain Amrinder Singh government must answer. You know, Punjab, Rahul, and you know this because you belong to the state, has been ridden with scams. We've seen land mafia, sand mafia, cable TV mafia, transport mafia, all sorts of scams in Punjab over the last few decades. But we never saw vaccine scam. Now we really have a situation where in the pandemic, when people are losing lives, a government which is, you know, losing support within its own members, within its own MLAs, is now hell-bent on using every opportunity to
Ajay
please
Kumar,
the people
respond
of Punjab
to Raghav Chadha. His direct charge is the only conceivable reason it makes sense for the state government to sell at 1,000 plus rupees to private hospitals and then there's another markup is because someone somewhere in the Punjab government made money. Otherwise, it simply makes no sense. Those vaccines should have been given either for free or at minimal cost. The government couldn't and shouldn't have wanted to profit here unless Raghav Chadha is alleging someone was making money.
You know, it's very rich on the Aam Aadmi Party to make such such statements. But why would a government make a noting on a file? I mean, if this is the corruption idea of a corruption, the government is officially saying it in a file. I mean, I can understand bad decision. It was reversed, except one second. I'll just complete round. I can understand bad decisions. And the government correctly said, they're in noting of the file saying that since the distribution of vaccines in the private sector are not available across any hospital except the two, so we have bought it for 400 and distributing to the rest of them. That, and whether it was a well thought out decision, debatable, and I agree. And since it did seem when it was, when the decision came, you know, so, was widely circulated, the government decided, look, it's a bad idea.
Okay, Manjinder Singh Sirsa,
No.
Congress's defense is that why would the state government make notings on a file if their intention was devious, that there had nothing to hide, this wasn't a scam, they weren't siphoning the vials off, they took a decision and they noted it down on file and they wouldn't do this if they thought their decision was wrong.
Rahul, first of all, I must tell you also and the panelist who is a Congress spokesperson here that the Chief Minister, the Chief Secretary of Punjab said on 24th of May that we are short of vaccines.
Correct.
And Government of India should provide us vaccines. I totally support her that Government of India should have provided more vaccines to them. But she never said that what vaccines will be getting to us, we will be making a profit of 660 rupees and then I will be selling in the open market. Now, what makes government sell that vaccine for a profit of 660 rupees, which government otherwise is getting for 400, first of all? Secondly, I'm a strong believer that Government of India should have given this vaccine for free of cost to the state government. But while Captain Amrinder Singh is selling this vaccine to the private hospitals, then he has got no moral right to ask that Government of India should give us free vaccine. Why? You are making a profit of 660 rupees on each vaccine, which Government of India is, you are getting for 400 rupees, first of all. Secondly, it is not about the vaccine selling to the market, open market. There were three modus operandi used for this vaccine. First, vaccine bazaar mein milegi nahi, sarkari hospital mein free milegi nahi kisi ko bhi. Then what choice he has? He has the only choice, that is, go to the private hospital. Now, private hospital are officially charging 1600 rupees. That is official. But nobody is getting jab for 1600 rupees. You have to pay another 1000 rupees to get that jab. I must tell you, I'm giving this statement with a very responsible person is giving a statement that they are not getting this for 1600 rupees. No, they have to pay another 1000 rupees apart from 1600 to get the jab. And second thing, not the third thing. When the entire Punjab is battling for COVID, where is their chief minister? Where is their health minister? They're sitting in Delhi. They are least concerned that state is fighting with COVID. There is a maximum fatality ratio in Punjab. Maximum people died in Punjab due to COVID. They have no hospitals. They don't get oxygen. they don't get beds, and now they don't get vaccine also.
Okay.
And
what Ajay the Kumar, doing? Respond
Sitting
to the Akali spokesperson.
And saying, madam, meri kursi bacha do. Do you think so? No, Rahul, one second. Tell me one thing. Isn't it a total insensitivity? क्या कोई देश के अंदर एक सूबे का मुख्यमंत्री इतना इनसेंसिटिव हो सकता है? सारी कांग्रेस के मिनिस्टर एमएलए पंजाब के गांधी परिवार के घर पर बैठे हैं, हमारी कुर्सी हमें दे दो, एक कह रहा है मेरी बचा दो, दूसरा कह रहा है मुझे दे दो क्या? और सेकंड थर्डली सोनिया गांधी इज ऑल्सो रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दिस, वाई उनको कहना चाहिए था वापस जाओ अपने स्टेट में, अपनी कुर्सियों की बात बाद में करना, पहले पंजाब के लोगों की जान की बात करो।
Okay.
तुम्हें शर्म नहीं आई यहाँ पे आते हुए?
अजय कुमार, दिस फोकस इज द लेंस वेरी स्क्वायरली कि बंदर की तरह कांग्रेस इज अटैक अगेंस्ट द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट्स वैक्सीन पॉलिसीज। यू हैव कांस्टेंटली बीन पुशिंग द गवर्नमेंट टू गिव वैक्सीन्स फ्री, व्हेन यू आर गेटिंग वैक्सीन्स फॉर 400 रुपीस, योर ओन गवर्नमेंट इज हाइकिंग द मार्जिन्स, प्रॉफिटियरिंग फ्रॉम द पेंडेमिक, and that just deflates your whole campaign of attacking the central government's vaccination policy, Ajay Kumar.
No, the first question is whether the vaccine, so I keep saying it, the fact is that people, my colleagues in the opposition have been saying that what is Mr. Amrinder Singh doing? He comes for the, throughout the pandemic, he stays and the whole government is fighting the pandemic in the state. He happens to come to Delhi for one day out of the hall of all these days. And suddenly it seems to have left Punjab totally to God. It's you know, not only very rich, it's really a very weak argument. But the other aspect is, I tell you, see, the question is, let's understand that whether governments make lots of decisions, and some of the decisions which government makes are bad. Now, this decision was definitely a bad decision. There's no debate on it. The government has withdrawn and said that we will and we will recompensate and all that. So that's one aspect to it. The fact
the government has not withdrawn. People forced them to withdraw. No, government has never withdrawn. People forced them, and opposition forced them to withdraw. So I request you, don't lie on national channel. It is people of Punjab and the opposition parties who forced Punjab government to withdraw this decision.
Why do you interrupt me?
Okay, go on, Ajay Kumar. Ajay Kumar, go on.
So, Sir, please show some respect. I don't interrupt you when you speak, and I would expect the same kind of courtesy extended.
Sorry.
Thank you. Now the issue is, I've been informed. First question. As a Congress spokesperson, I have been informed officially that the order has been withdrawn and it has been, and there will be an inquiry on this decision. Now, this is an official statement which I have been informed, and I'm again telling you that the government, when it makes a decision on file, I don't know what the total impact of this, you can do the maths, 600 into 40,000 doses. I'm telling you on your show, Rahul, that it was a bad decision. The government accepted it, took its feedback. The other side is the Bharatiya Janata Party and our other colleagues. We have been saying that the vaccine policy is a bad decision, but nobody wants to take it back because they believe that they are the smartest guy in town. We said, listen, this decision was bad. We accept our mistake.
Okay.
We withdraw
that, let R.P. Singh respond to that. You're saying we've accepted it's a bad decision.
Rahul
we've taken it back. And the BJP should do the same. You've got a bad vaccine policy according to the opposition. And they want you to take it back. Let R.P. Singh respond, please. R.P.
Sorry, go ahead.
Ajay Kumar, it's not just a bad decision. It stinks of corruption. 550 rupees margin for a private hospital for 80,000 vaccine. It has been caught on step one when you have been caught there. But this could have gone to 8 lakh vaccine or more than that vaccine. And this amount would have totaled to something like 44 crore rupees. So this stinks of corruption, because why will a government which is getting a vaccine for 400 rupees, giving it for 10 or 50 rupees, which is being furthered vaccinated for 650 rupees. But that's not merely, you can just wash off your hand by saying, oh, it was a wrong decision. It was an administrative decision. It was a decision which CM never knew. It was a decision which the health minister never knew. No, sir. Sir, someone got the money. Someone got the kick in between. Who got the kick in between? That is the issue. But this has been caught a step and it looks a small thing. But had it continued, then this would have been much bigger. The scam is much bigger.
So you're making it seem, let Raghav Chadha also come in, he wants to make a point. You're making it seem as if it's a very big scam. I'm just trying to do some maths. If you look at the total doses involved, the Punjab government is saying this is only 4,000 doses and 40,000 doses. Therefore, it's not a very big scam. It's not
as if,
it isn't as if this was done for all the vaccines available in Punjab.
80,000 doses,
for a very small part. Let Raghav Chadha come in. Raghav?
Look, Rahul, first of all, it is not about the Yes. So, Rahul, first of all, we aren't exactly sure of the numbers because the government of Punjab hasn't, put out the exact numbers, the doses of vaccines that were made available to these private hospitals. Only sources have been quoted in news reports. That point number one. Point number two, on the question of file notings, that merely because there is a file noting of this sale from the government to the private hospital, it cannot be a scam or it cannot be an illegal transaction. Merely because there is a file noting, this argument is erroneous. From Beauforts to Colgate, all scams that have happened in India have file notings. Merely because there is a file noting doesn't mean that there cannot be a scam or there cannot be illegal gratification involved in the process. That's point number one. Point number two, the health minister of the state of Punjab, Mr. Balbir Sidhu, was asked this very question, I think yesterday or day before, as to why these vaccines are being sold to the private hospital. You know what he said, Rahul? He said that I am not involved in the process. Please don't ask me. Ask my boss, ask someone else in the government. I am not involved. I have no clue of this. So that means perhaps the health minister was also not kept in the know. It was done directly by the chief minister or the chief minister's office. And therefore, the Congress party really needs to answer. Point number three, Rahul. Governments usually, generate funds for vaccines. You have a situation in Punjab where the government is generating funds from vaccines, by sale of vaccines. And it is only under some very rare circumstances, Rahul, can a drug which is as important as this can be sold if you have vaccinated the entire state, if the state requires no more vaccines, and if the vaccines are nearing its expiry. Even then, there is a process to sell these medicines and these vaccines. You have to float a tender, and the person who quotes the highest price should be given those vaccines or the drug after inoculating every citizen of the state of Punjab. Now you have a situation where nobody has been inoculated. A very abysmal part of the population has been inoculated. The state government has run out of vaccines. Government-run centers are shut. But the state government is hell-bent on booking profit by selling these vaccines in a completely arbitrary fashion, perhaps for illegal gratification, to private hospitals. So therefore, it certainly merits an investigation. These are serious allegations.
Will
and the
that be a proper investigation, Ajay Kumar? You've just taken the decision back because you realized it was wrong. But will we get to the bottom of whether money exchange hands?
First question is the amount, the maths is around, if I remember, if my arithmetic is right, is 2.4 crores. What are we talking? I mean, the first question is all these national spokesperson on this channel are saying, scam. Officially 40,000, 2.4 crores, the total consideration, if you look at the 600 rupees, 400 rupees from what the government bought and 600 rupees, what they said, is 2.4 crores. So let's do the maths. So now, Raghav, one sec. Aam Aadmi Party says sending liquor during COVID time by home delivery is a great deal of financial decision making. Selling liquor during COVID time and delivering liquor to the house is very apt way of good governance. And generating profit by doing home delivery of liquor gives them a halo of integrity. And this amount which we are discussing today, when we said it's 2.4 crores. So anybody who wants some sense
of... So at least you accept that there has been an illegal gratification of 2.4 crores? Are you accepting, Ajoyji, that there has been an illegal gratification of 2.4 crores?
2.4 crores is the profit the government is making. The government is making, my friend. That is the maths.
What is the kickback? Is there a kickback?
No, get the maths
what is
straight.
The kickback?
It is 2.4 crores
for
the government. It's a file.
Did the private hospitals pay any minister in the government?
Okay. Everybody can't speak at the same time. Everybody can't speak at the same time. Manjinder Singh Sirsa, Ajay Kumar says, you're making a mountain out of a molehill. The principle may have been wrong, but the amount involved is very small. Mr. Sirsa.
And government gets that amount.
Let him speak. Manjinder Singh sir.
आपको लग रहा है because चोर चोरी करते पकड़ा गया उसी वक्त पकड़ा गया चोर अगर चोरी करते पकड़ा जाए और उसने अगर अभी बैंक में से कम पैसा चुराया तो इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि वो बाकी पैसा नहीं चुराने वाला था ये अमाउंट को आप अभी मत कंसिडर करो पहले तो आप ये बताओ राहुल आई मस्ट टेल यू वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग एंड वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट ऑल्सो यू मस्ट नॉट बी अवेयर ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट श्रोमणी गुरुद्वारा प्रबंधक कमेटी is giving free jabs, free vaccination kar rahi hai. We are buying for 1,060 rupees and giving for free. We asked the state government preferred to sell it to the private hospital, but they never gave us at 400 rupees. Because, why? Because they want to make a profit. Now the question is not about the 40,000 vaccination. No, It is about 8 lakh, 10 lakh, and 20 lakh, and then 30 lakhs. You know what they did? Sare sarkari hospital band kar diye gaye hain. There is no vaccination plan in Punjab. Now, what people are left with choice? They have no choice at all. Gareeb aadmi ke paas pehle ilaaj karane ko paise nahi hai. इनके पास बेड नहीं है, ऑक्सीजन नहीं है. अब उसके बाद उसकी जो दवाई वैक्सीनेशन थी वो भी ले ली. अब क्या है, ये एक अमीर लोगों के लिए धंधा बन गया. पैसा कमाओ, मैंने आपको जैसे बताया, इट इज़ नॉट फॉर 1600 तो वो बिलिंग पे ले रहे हैं. इसके अलावा वो 1000 रुपया पर वैक्सीनेशन चार्ज कर रहे हैं. आप रजिस्ट्रेशन कराएं, वो कह रहे हैं okay, रजिस्ट्रेशन अवेलेबल नहीं है.
एंड उन्होंने गलत कोरोना इंडिया डैशबोर्ड एंड शो यू वेयर पंजाब स्टैंड्स वीज़ावी अदर स्टेट्स, व्हिच इज रियली व्हाट वी शुड हैव बीन फोकसिंग ऑन. Rather than the Punjab government looking to turn the pandemic into an opportunity to make money, they should have really focused on the numbers in Punjab. I'm going to pull out the daily update for India and show you the overall cases and where Punjab stands in them. 2,144 cases in terms of the overall number of cases over the last 24 hours. Punjab registered 92 deaths in the last 24 hours. It's amongst the states with the maximum number of cases at this moment. On a pan-India basis, at this moment, Punjab stands at number 17 between Telangana and Assam. And I'll call up over here, the yellow curve registers the total number of cases. The green curve registers the number of people who've recovered. The blue curve registers the current number of active cases. And the red curve registers the number of deaths. But Punjab at this moment is behind Bihar, behind Telangana, behind Haryana, Madhya Pradesh. So RP Singh, the government of Punjab can argue, if you look at how Punjab is net to the rest of the country, it isn't so bad, because Maharashtra, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Delhi also have been seeing way more cases than Punjab has. So net, Punjab hasn't done quite as badly as some of the other states in the battle against COVID.
Rahul, I'll appreciate you should show the fatality rate also. That's 2.8%, which is much more than the other states. I mean, please do that comparison also. Then we'll understand where did Punjab fail, one. Secondly, Rahul, we are letting him go by saying that there's a small amount, there's a paltry amount. Sir, he has been caught at step one. Was there any tender floated for vaccination? No. You wanted, how can government do anything without bringing the public notice? And you're saying, oh, the man is saying it's a very small amount. Sir, you have been caught, that's why you're saying small amount. But this would have blown into a big deal. And then I'm accusing that there is much more than what we can see through. Otherwise, why would government give a vaccination which is for a poor man to hospitals to sell it at a premium? And then government is making money out of, I've never seen government making money out of pandemic or crisis.
You know, but all of this is happening at a time
that
when
government
there is
making money out of crisis.
Okay, this is all happening at a time when the Punjab chief minister is fighting another battle. With just months to go for the assembly elections, rebellion has hit the Punjab Congress. Dissidents are complaining about the captain's style of functioning. Navjot Singh Sidhu is seen positioning himself as an alternate leader. In the middle of all of this, Captain Amrinder Singh today appeared before a three-member Congress panel to put forward his defense.
There are still more than 8 months left for elections in Punjab, but rumblings have already started in the Congress state unit. Chief Minister Amrinder Singh touched down in Delhi to quell dissent within the party in the state. Congress MLAs have been upset with Amrinder Singh, claiming that his government was being run by bureaucrats. The Bargadi sacrilege issue has further divided the ruling party. The Congress High Command has tasked a three-member panel of Mallikarjun Kharge, J.P. Agarwal and Harish Rawat to resolve the disunity in the party. The panel met with Punjab CM Amrinder Singh as well as MLAs including Navjot Singh Sidhu to sort out the differences.
के सामने रखे हैं और मुख्यमंत्री ने कहा है कि वो इसका समाधान निकाले.
जो भी कहा, जिसने कहा वो उनको बता दिया, उन्होंने अपना अपना वो दे दिया, जो एक्सप्लेनेशन थी बस.
रिपोर्ट तैयार कर रहे हैं आप लोग?
हाँ जी हाँ.
अच्छा, कब तक भेजेंगे हाईकमान को?
कल परसों तक भेज देंगे.
रिस्पेक्टिंग
The panel is likely to submit a report this weekend to Sonia Gandhi on the rift, and in all likelihood, there will be changes in the cabinet and in the party.
क्या विचित्र राजनीति चल रही है? पूरा पंजाब कोरोना से प्रभावित है. आज तो पूरा पंजाब पार्टी और सरकार दिल्ली में है पिछले तीन चार दिन से. वहां पंजाब को कौन देखेगा?
अमरिंदर इज अनबेंडिंग, रेडी टू फाइट इट आउट विद द कांग्रेस हाई कमांड, इवन इफ इट मींस अ स्प्लिट इन द पार्टी. बिफोर ही मेट द थ्री मेंबर पैनल इन दिल्ली, the chief minister even posed with rebel AAP MLAs Sukhpal Singh Khera and two other legislators who have joined the Congress. But he has not answered any questions on what his game plan is. He is keeping his cards close to his chest.
हमारी छह महीने के अंदर इलेक्शन आ रही है, एंड दिस इज इंट्रोस्पेक्शन जो हम अपनी पार्टी में करते हैं, और वो ही किया है हमने.
The chief minister has even projected himself as Punjab the captain on his Facebook page, sending a clear signal that he will be the CM face in the next elections too.
4 days of peacemaking exercise to quell infighting in Punjab unit has come to an end, and the ball rests in the court of party high command. Sources say Badal's escaping charge sheet in the sacrilege case remains the central issue, and there's pressure on Captain Amrinder to deliver pre-poll promises as the countdown to 2022 polls has begun. With camera person Helen, this is Anand Patel in New Delhi for India Today.
Is this a part of the reason, Ajay Kumar, why the Punjab government has been, you know, caught off guard, that there's so much political fire that they're busy dousing? Internal sniping taking place, and that's obviously the hugest concern as Punjab gets ready for the elections next year.
No, Rahul, look, I started with the point that the government also realizes it's a bad decision, and I would like the, you know, my co-panelists also to check on what's like RP Singh Saab seemed to be very agitated on what's happened in Punjab, and rightfully so, as a political person, he must be. But was he as agitated with Tejasvi Surya officially?
And that was not even the government.
Tejasvi Surya and his uncle selling and putting advertisements in Bangalore newspaper, buy at 900 rupees with a recording of the hospital saying, I have to give 700 rupees to Mr. Ravi Subramanian. There's a recording. Forget anything else. There's an official recording. Wow. So I would, at the BJP is the ultimate scam, because the 150 rupees central government buying and rest of it state government buying at 400 odd rupees and private buying, this scam should be correlated with what happens to the anonymous electoral bonds, and why is BJP pushing for these two or three companies?
Okay,
only to
RP Singh, before I conclude, you're raising questions about what's happening in Punjab. Ajay Kumar saying you didn't bother criticizing what was happening in Karnataka, and that shows your double standards.
See, Rahul, there's a saying in Punjabi, Lucha Sapto Ucha. You will understand. I think, I doubt Ajay Kumar will understand. Raghav and Sirsasa will understand. So they are making noise because they've been caught. And also, sir, there is a lot of infighting and there's a lot of corruption charges being leveled by each other. There's an already inquiry going on against Navjot Singh Sidhu by Captain himself. Prakat Singh is on record saying that I've been threatened by Captain's OSD, saying that you better fall in line or otherwise we'll open your files. But what is going on in Punjab? And to cover it up, they come here. To sort it out, they come here. And then at the door of Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi, and then without bothering about what's happening in Punjab. They are not bothered about Punjab. And I asked you, requested you, please show the mortality rate of Punjab also. How many deaths have happened comparing to other states? And Ajay Kumar ji, you have all the right to make noise about everything else, but let's talk about what's happening in Rajasthan. How many jabs have you wasted? And how many jabs you have thrown in dustbin? Let's talk about Chhattisgarh. What's the state you come from? What's happening there also?
Rahul, again,
Rahul, may I very briefly respond?
It has been again repeatedly, RP Singh Saab, the government has replied, it's lies by the BJP, and it's sad that the
Sir,
central government.
Ajay Kumar ji,
you have been caught.
RP Singh Saab, accept it and hold an inquiry into it. hold an investigation into it. Instead of threatening your within party opposition,
can I hold
inquiry into it.
This is the first time that a central government
sir,
is
only one answer, sir. When will you hold inquiry into this?
RP Singh, let him respond, please.
Which has been caught at step one.
You know, Rahul, the government of Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan replied that the percentage of wastage they've shown is totally false. It's shameful that a central government now is dividing India between
sir,
states, fighting, and it's shame. I mean, I feel it's a very sad
record,
situation.
Sir.
Okay, Raghav Chadda, final words. Sir. I'm running out of time. Quickly, Raghav.
Rahul, very briefly, you see, as somebody who's the in charge for the Aam Aadmi Party for the state of Punjab, somebody who travels extensively to Punjab, is somebody who's a Punjabi. Let me tell you, Rahul, the government in Punjab has been missing for the last 4.5 years. Captain Amrinder has outsourced his governance to one bureaucrat, who's his principal secretary. He's outsourced his politics to a political strategist. And he himself has, left his bungalow, left his secretariat and moved to a plush farmhouse. Number two, at a time when the entire ruling party and the Punjab administration should have been fighting COVID, they are fighting each other. And please don't go by the figures put out by the Punjab government, Rahul. They are not reporting the mortality case and they are not reporting the mortality numbers as well as the positivity numbers. Even when they underreport, even then the mortality rate of the state of Punjab is the highest in the country and 2.5 times the national average. Now, the Captain Amrinder government has miserably failed on, as far as administration and governance is concerned. Not even a single manifesto promise has been kept. And the most, troublesome times for mankind, that is this pandemic. In this pandemic, the government of Punjab has been completely absent. All ministers, all MLAs have been fighting each other. One wishes to become the chief minister.
Okay.
The other wishes to become the deputy chief minister. The entire government is in Delhi, stationed at Akbar Road, and not on the streets of Punjab, saving the lives of people.
I'm out of time. Since those are direct charges against the Congress, I'm going to give Ajay Kumar 20 seconds to respond and conclude.
Raghav is saying about death numbers, I mean, there is an interesting report on Delhi death numbers, which I think would educate the Aam Aadmi Party on saying how much it was underreporting. The question is, today's discussion was on the vaccine issue. We said that it was a decision which on hindsight didn't seem to be appropriate. If we took it back, the amount which was being touted out as a scam was 2.4 crores. And I would expect RP Singh and people of the opposition to raise those issues. But I would also expect them to start inquiry against Tejasvi Surya and the Ravi
okay.
Subramaniam.
So I'm out of time. I want to thank our guests, Manjinder Singh Sirsa, Raghav Chadda, RP Singh, Ajay Kumar. I think Ajay Kumar said bad decision more often than he ever has in his life. They're accepting at least that this was a wrong decision, but it is very bad optics to be seen as profiteering in a pandemic, selling to private hospitals at twice the price the state government received the vaccine jabs from the center is just terrible optics in the middle of a pandemic and as we head to the big Punjab elections next year. I'm slipping into a break. When we come back, Google apologizes for hurting Kanadiga's sentiments after a search result shows